to say. It was fantastic.
It was really, yeah, Penny, what was her name?
Penny Pingleton?
Penny Pingleton, I don't know. She was a very, very obsessed, unhappy woman. and I got to do it. There were a lot of ad-libs I did in that. I don't know if you got to ad-lib in your stuff, but
I didn't get to ad-lib that much.
Oh, yeah, Devil Child was hilarious. Really fun to come
Okay, so now everybody has to go watch Hairspray again and just relive these moments and just laugh a little bit. Anna was here, and here's a photo that she tweeted of you two. Break it down for me, woman.
Well, I'll tell you, that's not the first kissing photo that has been tweeted of between me and Anna. I don't know if the other one is out there, and then we've just decided it's our thing. We are going to just inappropriately kiss at odd moments and.
Why not?
Tweet them. It's just kind of fun.
I grew up in Jersey, and I grew up around a lot of Puerto Ricans, and it's normal. And I said, let's kiss Anna.
And Anna Faris is incredibly kissable. She is the sweetest woman on the planet. Very soft lips.
Precious.
Very big heart. Sweetest. I landed in a pot of jam working with her. Truly.
And she got the baby. Have you seen the baby? There's a baby running around.
The most adorable little boy I've ever seen in my life. Jack. And he has these, he wears glasses. And on a boy that's like.
Let me tell you something. You want to get anything out of me, bring a baby with glasses. Around, I turn into mush around. Any little kids with glasses are just like the cutest thing.
I have a picture of Jack, which I would love to share with you, but it's in my dressing room.
Well, you'll have to do that. Now, Bonnie is a different character.
Oh, yeah.
We've seen you play so many different characters, but Bonnie is fun. She's juicy.
Yeah.
She gets spicy.
She's real inappropriate and without boundaries. And
I know your mom watches everything you do. What does your mom think of Bonnie?
Mom didn't take to Bonnie too much. In the beginning, I think she was a little shocked by the things that Bonnie does and says, but being my mother, she is loyal. She's watched every week, and she actually, she says, you know, I actually kind of love the show now. It took her a while, but
right.
She, because I usually, every part I play, there's some part of my mother in it, because I just find her hilarious. Not that she's not stand-up hilarious, but just the things that are important to my mother just find me, they just endlessly amuse me. The fact that she will go to, you know, DEF CON, you know, what's the highest DEF CON
like
you can
four,
go to?
Right?
Four? I don't know.
In the movies, it's usually DEF CON 5. DEF CON 10. What, corn is like DEF CON 10. I didn't know we had a DEF CON 10. Do we have any military personnel to clarify with the DEF CON?
Anyway, she gets, if there's not enough chocolate Santas at the table for Christmas, she goes to DEF CON 5. And and she'll call me with weird things like, she calls me Ati. She says, Ati, do you have any use for a hot towel rack? And I just do things that
just random.
She cares about and are important just make me laugh.
She
I don't
wants
know.
You to have
she wants
hot
to
towels.
Have me have a hot towel rack. She wants to make sure there are enough chocolate Santas. They're just, her behavior is funny to me.
Well,
I love her
have
dearly.
Plenty of chocolate Santas.
Well, yes.
I mean, I thought that was a given. Everybody knows you got to have a lot of chocolate.
Well, because if you don't have enough for everyone around the table, how are you going to do? You can't split a chocolate. You can't decapitate Santa at Christmas.
Right.
You
know, it gets tricky. It gets tricky, especially with the kids and then Santa, and then it's emotional. You know?
Don't want to mess with Santa like that.
So you're in this new movie, Bad Words, Jason Bateman's directorial debut here, right?
I didn't realize it was his directorial debut until after the fact, because he is so, he had such command of that set and knew exactly what he wanted. He's so funny. Have you spent time with him?
Every time I've been around, he's just...
I love it. I did Juno with him, and we didn't do any scenes together, but I fell in love with him on the press junket.
Right.
Because it's just more fun when he's around. Everything's
more
fun. Well, it's about his character. He sort of enrolls in this spelling bee that's run by my character. He finds a loophole, because spelling bees are usually for 8th graders and 7th graders. And he finds a loophole that says that as long as you haven't graduated 8th grade, you can be eligible. And he gets into the spelling bee and just is my nemesis. The parents are all an uproar, and you don't find out until the end, why is this man doing this? Why is he insisting on competing and humiliating all these young kids? And this, it's very funny, but it turns to it's a very poignant and has a lovely message, but getting there is quite a wild.
I can't wait to see the whole thing. Let's take a look at a clip.
You know, when I was a little girl, I was always picked last in P.E.
I hated sports. That's what probably, thankfully, thrusted me into the welcoming bosom of the Spelling Bee, of which I am the director, have been for over 20 years now. How did I accomplish that? Elbow grease? Yes. Hard work? Maybe. Integrity? Oh, you betcha. But what I didn't do is use slimy gimmicks as you have done.
Well, you don't know me and you don't know why I'm here.
Would you like to tell me?
When we come back, I got a forbidden challenge for Allison. Don't go anywhere!
Selling your car? Well, here's some great news from WeBuyAnyCar.com.
WeBuyAnyCar!
You are in Mr. Peabody and Sherman.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my goodness, this is so exciting.
I know.
The kid in me is just kind of coming back.